Good afternoon, and welcome to our virtual final assembly. My name is Jonas Jeswald, and I am the head of middle school here at Germantown Academy. Before we dive into the virtual program this year, I feel like it is important to begin by acknowledging that this school year has been unlike any other that the middle school students or I have experienced in our lifetime. This spring has seen not only the unprecedented challenges of COVID-19 and launching a virtual middle school, but also the tragic murders of George Floyd and Ahmaud Arbery. I hope you will join me for a moment of quiet reflection. I ask that you take this moment to honor the lives of Mr. George Floyd and Ahmaud Arbery and all of the 100,000 plus lives we have lost to COVID-19. I ask you to lift up and support all of the first responders, doctors, nurses, and all of you who have taken time to support our community. I also ask you to lift up and support those who are rightfully protesting and exercising their freedom of speech, and those who have been impacted in significant ways through the violence and looting in recent days. Please join me in a moment of quiet reflection now. Thank you. All right, classes of 2026, 2025, and 2024. Whoop, whoop. We have arrived at the culminating event of the 2019-2020 school year, final assembly. For the next hour or so, we will acknowledge and celebrate all that we have accomplished together this year. To begin our program, I would like to introduce our esteemed head of school, Mr. Rich Shellhaus. Rich?
Heartiest greetings, middle school students, parents, families, faculty, and staff. I'm Rich Shellhaus, the head of school here at GA, and I want to congratulate you on a strong finish to a great but different school year. Who would have thought back in September when we were gathered to start the year on Connor Quad during flag raising that we would finish the last quarter of the year in such a different setting? Together, but not exactly together. I want to thank the students for embodying GA's motto. By persevering, you will see the fruits. You have seen the fruits, my friends, and you've done a fantastic job. I want to thank the faculty for their Herculean efforts in creating virtual GA and making the most of a very complicated situation. And of course, I want to thank the parents and families for all of your support. It's important today that we also take a moment to thank Mr. Jeswald, for in March, he was charged with the nearly impossible task of creating something from nothing. And he has done so with great intelligence, humor, passion, love, care, and not just a little bit of magic. Mr. Jeswald, we are eternally indebted to you. Finally, class of 2024, you have finished your middle school years strong. What a triumph for you during this vital time in both your education and your lives. Your teachers and I know that you are more than ready for the increased opportunities, privileges, and responsibilities which await you in high school. Know this, you get one chance at upper school, so take a deep breath, prepare to dive in fully, and really take advantage of everything that awaits for you in your ninth grade year. Your teachers and I know that you can do it. We're so proud of you, and I wish you well. I can't wait to see what you accomplish next year. Have a fantastic summer. Congratulations, class of 2024.
The Art Award is given to an eighth grade student who approaches art making with passion and an open imagination. This recipient has worked vigorously with commitment and excellent craftsmanship to achieve his or her vision. It is my pleasure to present the Art Award to AJ DeFranco.
The Drama Award for Excellence in Theater Performance. This award goes to an eighth grader whose desire for success is guided by hard work, dedication, and passion for the arts. Their endeavors are distinguished by excellence in musical and or dramatic performance. This year's award goes to Liam Richardson Harris.
The English Award is presented to a student in the eighth grade for extraordinary skill in reading and writing, a consistent commitment to the creative process, and an unabashed love for the written and spoken word. It is my pleasure to present this year's award to Emma Moyer.
My name is Jim Eichstead. I'm head of the Middle School History Department, and I'm here to present the History Award. The History Award is presented to the student who passionately delves into the study of the past, who seeks to uncover patterns and make connections across cultures and time periods, and who articulates their ideas clearly and powerfully, both verbally and in writing. I am pleased to present the History Award to Isabel Liu. Great job and congratulations.
I'm Jared Anderson, and I'm the head of Modern and Classical Languages. The Modern and Classical Languages Awards are presented to four eighth grade students of Mandarin Chinese, French, Latin, and Spanish. These students' language skills are ferocious and ambitious. Their sensitivity to a new culture, precocious and auspicious. Their propensity for play and risk-taking in a new tongue, infectious and prodigious. It is my delight to present the Mandarin Chinese Award to Elizabeth Scheid. To present the French Award to Saloni Bhatia. To present the Latin Award to Andre Vava. And to present the Spanish Award to Olivia Cray. Congratulations all.
Hello, my name is Matt Notary, and I'm the Middle School Mathematics Department Head. The Mathematics Award is given to an eighth grade student in the Middle School Mathematics program who has demonstrated excellence in mathematics through attitude, effort, achievement, and originality of approach. It's my pleasure to present the award to Ada Kaplan. Congratulations, Ada.
Hi, my name is Chris Horner, and I'm the Middle School Performing Arts Department Head. It's my pleasure to present this year's Music Awards. The Music Performance Awards are presented to outstanding eighth grade students in the Senior Chorus, the Concert Band, and the String Ensemble who demonstrate overall musicianship and a spirit of teamwork within their ensembles. This year, the Senior Chorus Award goes to Jennifer Durnau. The Concert Band Award goes to Ange Kakadia. And the String Ensemble Award goes to Ada Kaplan. Thanks so much to all of you for all of your hard work, and congratulations to all.
The Physical Education Award is presented to the student who best embraces a holistic approach to fitness, demonstrating exceptional skills, inspiring leadership, and respectful teamwork within the physical education environment. This year's recipient is Caitlin Picorni.
The Science Award is given to the eighth grade student who asks thought-provoking questions, who perceives the universe from many different perspectives, and who enthusiastically tries to understand the phenomena of life. This year, it is my pleasure and honor to give the award to Carmela Jenks.
Traditionally, I invite a member of the middle school faculty to give some brief remarks at final assembly. This year, however, I decided to change things up, and I invited all middle school faculty members to submit a brief video for the class of 2024 with a message of a hope that they have for the class or a piece of advice that they would have given their eighth grade selves. I am grateful to Mr. Dion Lehman for compiling these videos into one, and I hope that you enjoy this year's faculty remarks.
Congratulations to the class of 2024. I'm so proud of all that you have accomplished during your years in the middle school. You have faced challenges and emerged as strong leaders in the classroom, on the stage, in athletics, and through your involvement in community service. Please remember to come back and visit your middle school teachers. I, for one, will miss you very much.
Dear class of 2024, you are glorious people. Continue to let your kind, upstander, that's right, I'm awesome, light shine on.
Congratulations, class of 2024. I'm so proud of you and how you've grown as students and as individuals. And my piece of advice for you is to always surround yourself with those that will help you become the best version of yourself. It's okay to step outside of your comfort zone and always, always be kind. Please visit next year. I'll miss you so much. Take care.
Class of 2024, congratulations. You pulled off a great year, and we really appreciate everything you did, especially at the end when things got toughest. I think maybe that's when you were at your best. We hope that you have a great future in upper school, and we hope that you'll come back to see us whenever you can.
Hello, class of 2024. As you move on to new and exciting adventures, my best advice to you is to be like Baby Yoda. Be kind, be brave, and take naps. Congratulations, class of 2024.
Hi, 8th graders. Mr. Eichstead here wishing you congratulations. We all had a big curveball thrown at us this spring, and the resilience you showed was great, and that will serve you well. I enjoyed teaching you. I hope you stay in touch. I want to wish you the best of luck in the future, and congratulations.
Class of 2024, congratulations. I can't believe it. You made it through middle school. Wow, it's such an awesome accomplishment, and I'm so proud of each and every one of you, especially you Dolan Advisory students from 6th grade. If I had any advice, it's to go outside your comfort zone. Make sure to try as many things as you can, because you never truly know what you're going to love, and any failure is an opportunity to grow. You're going to do great things moving forward, and I love you guys. Congratulations.
Felicitaciones, class of 2024. I know the end definitely wasn't easy, but you did it. If there's one piece of advice I could go back and give my 8th grade self, it would be that it is okay to change your mind. Even after you've already started something, even when you think you can't, it is always okay to rethink what you want to do and who you want to be. Congratulations again, and good luck in the upper school.
Class of 2024, sorry I couldn't finish the year in person. I really miss seeing you guys. I just wanted to say that I'm giving you the best wishes as you move up into upper school. And here's a little bit of advice. Just be yourselves and approach life with an open mind. Good luck.
Hi, class of 2024. Congratulations. Take this time to pause, reflect, and be proud of all the accomplishments and how much you have grown throughout your time in middle school. Enjoy the moment and best of luck as you start your journey in the upper school. Have a great summer. You deserve it.
Dear class of 2024, I miss you and wish we could all be together, but want to pass along all of my congratulations and well wishes as you finish middle school. I hope that in the years ahead, you find ways to get more involved in the things that bring you happiness and fulfillment. I also hope that you judge yourself based on your own goals and merits rather than comparing yourself to others. Wishing you all much success and happiness, and please don't forget to visit us.
To the class of 2024, congratulations. I hold a special place in my heart for all of you, not because I've known so many of you since your lower school days, but because as a class, you carry yourselves with confidence and maturity. Hold on to these traits as you head on to the upper school, and remember to be kind to one another and to always try to consider things from someone else's perspective. I will miss you, and I wish you all the very, very best.
Congratulations, class of 2024. If I could give my 8th grade self a piece of advice, I would take it from the main character of Piecing Me Together, Jade. At the end of her big collage that she made, she wrote over it, "Be bold, be brave, be brilliant, be beautiful, be your best self." Congratulations, and please come back and visit your middle school teachers.
Congratulations, class of 2024. You are a great class, and I hope that over the next 4 years, you really take the time to know each other and to appreciate the talents and strengths and interests that you all have. We're going to miss you in middle school, but we know you're going to do great things in upper school. Congratulations.
Class of 2024, congratulations on your completion of middle school. If there's one thing that these past few weeks have taught us, it's not to take any moment for granted. As you head off to upper school, I encourage you to continue to make yourself better, as well as the community as a whole. Find ways to embrace challenges and engage in your community. But most importantly, as you continue to grow up, be comfortable with who you are, because you know yourself best. Class of 2024, I congratulate you. I will miss you and have a fantastic summer.
Hi, eighth graders, congratulations. We are so proud of you and all the work you've accomplished in middle school. We wish we could celebrate with you in person. A piece of advice I would have given to my eighth grade self is to trust your voice. Also important to listen to the voices and experiences of others. We look forward to seeing all the work you guys do in the next 4 years and in the years to come. Have a great summer.
Hi, class of 2024. I just wanted to give you a little piece of advice that I wish someone gave me when I was wrapping up my eighth grade year. And that is, when you come back to school in September, I want you to press the restart button and not think about picking up where you left off, but to think about the direction that you want this new journey to go in and how you want it to begin.
Congratulations, class of 2024. You should be proud of all that you've accomplished during your time in middle school. But you didn't do it alone, so I hope that you will take the time to thank those who cared for you and supported you along the way. And I also encourage you to strive to care for and support each other as you move on to upper school.
Class of 2024, congratulations on all that you've accomplished to this point. I wish you nothing but great successes with your future endeavors. And remember, work hard, play hard, and always do it in that order. Good luck.
Congratulations, class of 2024. You made it. I hope you enjoy your summer. You're about to embark on some of the best years of your life. I hope that you embrace and seek out opportunities in upper school and beyond. Those opportunities for learning, opportunities to connect, opportunities to learn and grow. It is an awesome time that you have to look forward to, and I wish you all the best.
Class of 2024, you made it. Bravo, félicitations. As you move with your life, I have one piece of advice. Don't be afraid to speak up. Be your own advocate. Your voice is important as any others. Bonne chance, les amis. Au revoir.
Congratulations, soon to be upper school students. A piece of advice I would give my eighth grade self is to consider that the activities and sports you're involved in are important in helping you build your character and take on challenges, but that they don't define you. It's okay to try new things, and moving on from old things doesn't mean you lose yourself. So know who you are at your core, know how you want to treat others, and then always be you.
Hey, eighth grade, my one piece of advice for you would be to not worry so much about everything, just enjoy being your 14-year-old self.
Eighth grade, congratulations on finishing middle school. But one word of advice to my eighth grade self, it would be to not be afraid to be vulnerable. That is the best way to connect with people, is when you're able to admit your own faults. So I would encourage all of you to keep that in mind, and I wish you nothing but the best in upper school. Keep in touch.
Congratulations, class of 2024, you made it. I could not have asked for a more kind and compassionate class to have spent my first 2 years at GA with. I'm going to miss you next year in the halls of middle school, and I hope that you come back to visit next year. I hope you have a great summer. Congratulations, class of 2024.
Congratulations, class of 2024. You did it. You're here. You survived. We're so proud of you. So wide stance, arms in the air, show your power pose. Congratulations.
Hello, my name is Byard Templeton, head advisor for the class of 2026, and I'm here to present the Geraldine T. Shipley Award. The Geraldine T. Shipley Award is awarded to a sixth grade student who has demonstrated an outstanding spirit of sportsmanship, both in the classroom and on the athletic field. It's my pleasure to present this year's Shipley Award to Cece Ficioris. Congratulations, Cece.
Hello, I am Pete Jennings, Assistant Athletic Director for Middle School, and it is my honor to present this year's Rulon E. Wetherill Award, awarded to a sixth grade student who has demonstrated an outstanding spirit of sportsmanship, both in the classroom and on the athletic field. It is my pleasure to present this year's award to Declan Dean.
Hello, everyone. My name is Jay Wright, and I am the head advisor for the class of 2025. Today, I will be presenting the Eileen M. Wallace 1760 Award. Established in honor of Eileen M. Wallace, teacher of English at the Academy, 1961 through 1992. Presented to a student in seventh grade who, in the opinion of faculty, meets challenges with perseverance and commitment and consistently demonstrates respect for others and loyalty to the school. This year's winner is Grace Boynton. Congratulations, Grace.
Good afternoon. I'm Dion Lehman, head advisor for the class of 2024, and I'm presenting this year's Edward R. Cast 1760 Award. Presented by the Parents Committee of the class of 1990 to the eighth grade student nominated by peers who exemplifies the qualities of integrity, compassion, and human understanding which guided Mr. Cast throughout his 16 years as headmaster of Germantown Academy. I'm pleased to give this year's award to Emma Moyer. Congratulations, Emma.
Hi, I'm Sarah Zimmerman, Middle School Academic Dean, and it's my honor to present this year's Francie Garvin Memorial Award. This award is presented to a girl nominated by her classmates in eighth grade who, by the fullest use of her natural capabilities in sports, studies, or outside activities, best represents the gallantry of spirit that characterized the life of Francie Garvin. I'm pleased to present this year's Garvin Award to Claire Durkin. Congratulations, Claire.
Hi, I'm Kate Cassidy, Director of Student Life in the Middle School, and it's my pleasure to present this year's Faculty Awards. Faculty Awards are presented by the middle school faculty to a 6th, 7th, and 8th grade student whose positive attitude, perseverance, and effort have led to exemplary academic and/or personal growth. This year's 6th grade Faculty Award is presented to Alexis Farnsworth. This year's 7th grade Faculty Award is presented to Eileen Wang. And this year's 8th grade Faculty Award is presented to Caitlin Picorni.
I'm head of school, Mr. Shellhaus, and it is my privilege to present today the Kershaw Medals. These are presented to students in the 6th and 7th grades for scholarship, deportment, honor, and general character in honor of Headmaster Dr. William Kershaw, who served from 1877 to 1915. Please note that the previous winners of the Kershaw Medals are now projected as well. The first winner of the Kershaw Medal for the class of 2026 is Caroline Higgins. The second winner for the Kershaw Medal in the class of 2026 is Stephen Tunnison. The first winner for the Kershaw Medal in the class of 2025 is Taryn DeFranco. And the second winner of the Kershaw Medal from the class of 2025 is Tyler Nolan. Congratulations.
The Owen J. Roberts Memorial Prize. Established by the Academy in memory of Justice Roberts, class of 1890, lifelong public servant and Associate Justice of the Supreme Court, 1930 to 1945. Awarded to two students in the eighth grade who best exemplify the originality of thought and independence of judgment which characterized the life and work of Justice Roberts. It is my pleasure to present these awards to Donica Staples and AJ DeFranco. Congratulations to both of you.
It is now time for one of my absolute favorite parts of the final assembly program, the student speakers. Each year we invite two students to give remarks at final assembly. One of the students is selected by their peers and the other by the middle school faculty. This year, the students have selected Andre Vava and the faculty have selected Emma Moyer. Emma and Andre have worked incredibly hard to prepare their remarks with the support of their English teachers and Mrs. Donchez, the English department head. Emma and Andre, we very much look forward to hearing what you have to say. Please join me in welcoming them.
Good afternoon. I would like to thank you all for giving me this opportunity to speak on behalf of the Germantown Academy Class of 2024. For many years, I recall wishing for time to go by faster. Looking across the crowns of oak trees in the quad, we would see our middle school graduating class and often wonder, why do they have so much freedom? That we should not walk the same halls, sing in their concert ensembles, and sprint across those distant fields seemed an injustice. At the time, this was entirely justified. We understood the world through young eyes, and it seemed that the ends of the world were mere steps away, and that our most ambitious aspirations were becoming reality. We simply had to wait. This ignorance, pleasant as it was, confounded our thoughts. It seemed to us that the countless years which separated us from our graduation were mere wastes of time. We wished that, perhaps, we may graduate tomorrow, and only then we would find ourselves suddenly responsible and, of course, truly free. Perhaps we could resettle beyond the horizon and there lay closer to the sun. However, this is not so. A sapling, yet too young to spread its leaves towards the skies, longs to uncover its roots and grow far from the community which raised it. Far too often does its impulse expose it to the rains, to the fires, and to the wind, and it grows no more. In these recent years of our lives, we have grown strong under the tireless care and dedication of our families and teachers. In the earliest grades, among our closest friends and colleagues, opportunities seemed boundless, error was trivial, and one day's troubles faded by the start of the next. Many lessons and the old memories of our friends came together, and soon the classmates who surrounded us became an integral part of who we have become. No longer did we define our thoughts from only our own imaginations, but found value and truth in the beliefs of others. And over years of interaction and discussion, our roots, those principles which guide and connect us, were strengthened, and the course of our leaves and branches became intertwined. And thus, a community was formed. Our community, however, was not the beginning of it all. Instead, it was but a stage in the centuries-long evolution of our school. In our envious and careful attention to those graduating students, we distinguished principles that we valued and desired of ourselves. As impressionable children, we found that we were cared for, and thus we cared for others. We saw those who embodied honor and courage, and we, too, wanted to embody that same honor and courage. And as we were respected, we came to respect all those who surrounded us. From this perspective, we see our grades as being a community within countless communities. Yet there exists another distinction between those long-established generations and our own, and that is experience. I believe that over the years, we become familiar with ourselves and embrace our passions and desires and accepted what challenges us. We have been shaped similarly by our successes as we have been affected by our failures. However, among the most difficult realizations is admitting our own mistakes. But as we come to experience it, we realize that failure should not be a cause of fear, but the source of resilience and hope. And by accepting these failures and challenges, we find responsibility. After all, responsibility is not the absence of failure, but the abundance of innovation and determination. Our community is, in truth, defined by those many experiences which we have undergone and the values which we have embraced. We have become exactly who we are today because of the convergence of the two, and there we found our identity. After our community has provided so much for us, we must realize that it is our own action and thought that impresses itself on those who come after us. And so it is time that we become the leaders of tomorrow and contribute to the diversity we have cherished for so long. We are the scholars and athletes, performers and writers, teachers and coaches, friends and family. We must share our common principles, sharing these visions of honor and deed, compassion in spirit, confidence in expression, and independence in thought. By cherishing the identity which defines each member of our community and embracing these common values, we become stronger and more adaptable. By harboring different flowers, we shall never find a day without blooms. Now, as we have been isolated in our homes many miles apart, the frail leaves of our youth, torn from their roots, could have withered away. Not so long ago, there appeared to be little hope that our community would survive undamaged. However, it is true, as our young minds once envisioned, that the present is limited only by the imagination and spirit that interprets it. We must find that power to see beyond the darkness of night and capture the distant light of dawn. And by finding this power in one another, we will always emerge triumphant. We must take many steps into the unknown in these years to come. And though these moments may bring great uncertainty, I am sure of one thing. No matter what may come upon us, we have shown in these difficult months that we can always find the strength to succeed. And now we step into the world of our future, together. Thank you.
Good afternoon, friends, family, students, faculty, and staff. My name is Emma Moyer, and I am in the 8th grade at Germantown Academy. Thank you for this opportunity to speak today. This year has been one full of the surprises and the unknown. A late night trek with only a small lantern. I am glad that we are still able to come together today. Whether we are in different towns or counties, states or countries, we are still able to come together and celebrate not only the class of 2024, but the hard work that 6th and 7th grade has put into this year as well. As we have aged, we have learned how to deal with the idea of one thing, change. It can take a lot of forms and impact the smallest pieces of our lives or the biggest ones, whether it's becoming the first grade to participate in the one-on-one tablet PC program or going to the upper school, change is uncontrollable and manipulative. Once it gets you to think that you are in control, it will throw the fastest curveball. On our 7th grade trip to Williamsburg, Mr. Lehman found that it took extremely long to take attendance on the buses. So what did he do? He started timing us. We raced to beat the other bus, but mostly ourselves. Sometimes we would be faster, other times slower. Working together and reaching towards a goal is how we not only improved, but became closer as a grade. We had no longer just been grouped together because of our age. We were a team. Often in school, there are group projects with 3 or 4 people, but this was different. We were a collage filled to the brim with purples and yellows, patterns and flowers, some vibrant and bold, others simple yet elegant, differing personalities and lives mixed together to create an efficient, thoughtful family. At the very beginning of 8th grade, we were competing in advisory wiffle ball games, a time to connect with the new advisory and kick the school year off with some fun. With a swing of a bat, the ball launched itself into the air, a plane flying overhead. Cohesivity at its best as we flung ourselves into the games, coming together and forming bonds as we played a simple game of baseball. Our true nature showed themselves as we connected on a deeper level while barely saying a word. By aiding each other on the sidelines or in the field, by knowing that we had each other's back, we became closer and stronger. Friendships grew from that day, and so did our grade. I feel that during quarantine and virtual GA, we have come together again, but this time we are stronger. We all have a better understanding of what the other is going through and can therefore support each other. Some have thrived in this environment, and others have fallen down. Together, though, with support and kindness, we have pushed through and adapted to this curveball, one that no one saw coming. I am proud of how close we have come as a grade and what we have been able to learn not only from this experience, but from our groundbreaking teachers. We face a different change soon, except this one we've always known about and prepared for. Our transition to the upper school may not have looked like the original plan, and the start of the 2020-2021 school year might not either. Our future is filled with the unknown and more surprises along the road. Through our hard times, we've had each other for support, and I know that we will be able to lean on each other again. The past has prepared us well for whatever challenges and change awaits us. We will get through it together, just as we have in the past. I look forward to next year with you all as we experience the good, the bad, and the everyday. Thank you so much.
Outstanding job, Andre and Emma. And now it's time for a special treat. We have a musical interlude, which is a presentation by the combined 6th, 7th, and 8th grade chorus. I'm tremendously grateful to Mr. Charlie Masters for pulling this together for today's final assembly program. Please enjoy.
I'll be the last one standing, two hands in the air, I'm a champion. You'll be looking up at me when it's over. I live for the battle, I'm a soldier. Yeah, I'm a fighter like Rocky. Put you flat on your back like Ali. Yeah, I'm the greatest, I'm stronger. Pay my dues, can't lose, I'm my own, yeah.
Through the drama, H for the hurt, but it's all for the honor. A for the attitude, working through the patience. Money comes and goes, so N is for motivation.
Gotta stay consistent, the B's for persevere. The I is for integrity, innovative career. The O's optimistic, open and never shut. And the N is necessary,
cause I'm never giving up.
See, they ask me how I did it, I just did it from the heart.
Pressing application, I've been doing from the start.
They say that every champion is all about his principles.
Truly special. Thanks again, Charlie. It's now time for me to turn it over to Mr. Lehman for the recognition of the class of 2024. And as I do, I want to make sure that you know that the first two instrumental musical pieces that you will hear behind the recognition were recorded by the string ensemble and edited by Mr. Chris Horner and the 7th and 8th grade band. And I believe that was edited by Jeremy Carenti and Mr. Delane Doyle. Mr. Lehman?
We are now at the point of the program where we get to recognize each individual member of the class of 2024 for reaching this milestone. To help in doing that, 8th grade advisors will be announcing the names of their advisees. And additionally, we'll be showing the 6-word memoirs created by our 8th grade students in a recent English class project. Before I hand the program off to our 8th grade advisors, I just want to say, as the head advisor for the class of 2024, how much of a blessing it's been to be your head advisor these past 3 years. You've been a wonderful class, and you've left this middle school better than it was when you started it. You're creative, you're talented, And what you've shown in these last couple weeks is that you're incredibly resilient and positive in the face of challenges. I admire you all, and I'm so grateful to have been your head advisor. Congratulations on this day, and have a great summer. And now I'm going to turn the program over to Romy Berkus to begin announcing the Berkus Advisory.
The Berkus Advisory. Anna Amen. Selena Bagchi. Christopher DiPlacido. Taryn Kaista. Rachel Cavinson. Maggie Morrissey. Nicholas O'Hara. Grant Pierce. Anna Ramirez. Liam Richardson Harris. And Elizabeth Shy.
This is the Eichstätt Advisory. Congratulations on a great year. Josh Bouchard. AJ DeFranco. Maddie Donchez. Veronica Gula. Caitlin Lozano. Max Magliari. Louisa McFarland. Lee Noble. Colin Rink. Brian Santangelo. Donica Staples.
Hello, I'm Corey Eklund, and it's a pleasure to announce the members of the Eklund Advisory. Salam Austin. Max Baer. Abby Durkin. Jennifer Dernal. Gavin Fountain. Carmella Jenks. Olivia Cray. Jordan Lee. Quinn Monahan. Emma Moyer. Daniel Shin.
Congratulations to the Financial Advisory, Alex Brereton. George Deming. Naomi Fleckman. Emma Goodwin. Emma Merrill. Ethan Page. Richie Padolka. Xander Shallow. Grace Taylor. Mario Toscano. Fred Zhang.
The Galante Advisory.
Nate
Chang. Chance Dooley. Will Irons. Ant Kakadia. Eva Kranak. Elaine Lee. Caitlin Picorni. Milo Ryan. Abby Swanson. Andre Bava.
I'm proud to present to you the Rominger Advisory. Congratulations, everyone. Ajit Baga. Eric Cross. Alyssa DePaul. John DeLello. Elijah Jones. Isabel Liu. Claire Murray. Travis Robertson. Noah Shapiro. Melinda Shen.
Zhao.
The Smith Advisory. Annabella Asimos. Maisie Betancourt. Charlotte Grimm. Abby Jacobs. Samantha Kostakos. Armin Meinstein. Jeff Nisman. Cooper Paul. Grace Peterson. Luke Phillip. Ryan Zepkowski.
I'd like to present the Stevens Advisory. Folks, thanks for a great year. Rania Al-Haddad. Sarah Grace Corin. Landon D'Ariano. Johnny DeMassey. Gabby Thalman. Sophie Goodridge. Seamus Knox. Devin Lukens. Jessica Pecorello. Sam Rofsky. Cole Snell.
It is my pleasure to introduce the Zerker Advisory. Nick Barron. Saloni Bhatia. Zara Bhatt. Trip Capers. Claire Durkin. Jonah Hunt. Ada Kaplan. JJ Murphy. Aiden Von Zubin. Angie Wang. Luke Zaki.
Hey, GA, this is Dr. McKean zooming in from San Francisco. I wanted to join you today to send along a really big hello to everyone, and especially huge congratulations to the graduating eighth graders who are finishing up their time in middle school today. I think, as you probably know, I'm going to be joining GA as the new head of upper school in just a few weeks, and I'm so excited for this next adventure. I think that these moments of transition, like what I'm experiencing and coming back to the East Coast from San Francisco, and what the eighth graders are experiencing today and finishing up their time in middle school, these are moments of reflection when we can pause and give thanks, I think, for the ways in which the place that we're leaving has nurtured us and helped us to grow, but then also really feel tremendous excitement for the next thing that is coming our way. And for me, this is GA, and I always think that there's also a really special bond between a new teacher or administrator who comes in and the first class that they're able to usher in to the school. And for me, this will be you. And so I'm really excited for this next adventure that we are going to embark upon together. I'm really excited to meet you very soon in a few weeks. And until I am able to see you in person, I send you all best wishes from the West Coast. And again, huge congratulations to you today.
Thanks so much, Dr. McKean. We look forward to welcoming you to GA as well. It's now time for the singing of the alma mater, and Mr. Masters, along with the middle school select chorus, have pulled together a really special version. I hope you will rise at home and join us in the singing of the alma mater.
Hail our alma mater to Germantown we sing. Cherished are the
Students, faculty, parents, family members, and friends who are watching, we are almost there. We're almost finished. I would be remiss if I didn't conclude this virtual final assembly with 2 points. First, I would like to express my gratitude to the middle school faculty and staff for their tireless work this year. Together, we created a virtual school in 3 days. Thank you to my amazing assistant, Ann Leonard, for her unending positive spirit and diligent work. And to the families of the class of 2024 and all of the middle school students, thank you for your partnership and support this year. I would also like to thank and congratulate the middle school students on behalf of the entire middle school faculty for a great year, though it was very different. Congratulations and thank you for persevering. We've missed seeing you in the hallways this spring, and we will miss seeing you in the virtual world this summer. Finally, and importantly, I need to thank our head of school, Rich Shellhaus, for his leadership throughout this entire year. Rich, I do not think that we would have been able to get here without your availability, leadership. It was truly amazing and greatly appreciated. Second, I need to share my own hope for the class of 2024. I'm not sure if you noticed, but there's a painting behind me on my wall. It was painted by my grandfather, Joe Jeswald, who was an artist and served our country in World War II. He painted this painting entitled The Fragile Golden Ball in 1993, when I was in eighth grade. And when he gave it to me, he also attached a letter to the back. It's still there now, and I'm actually gonna grab it for you and read it. I promise it's very brief. I think you can see the painting. December 1993. Dear Jonas, there is room for your own interpretation of this image, of course, but I see the golden ball as a symbol of those humane qualities that some people possess. It is, unfortunately, rare. The ball is precious and fragile. I think you have one and will keep it always. Much love, Grandpa Joe. While I agree with my grandfather about the fragility of the golden ball, I disagree on one important point. I believe that all of us have our own golden ball. My hope, class of 2024, is that you will find yours if you haven't already and carry it with you at all times. We need you to do so now more than ever. Congratulations, middle school. The 2019-2020 school year has officially come to a close. Class of 2024, we look forward to celebrating you tomorrow at 3:30 on campus during our drive-through celebration. Please be sure to read the instructions, the email with instructions that I sent. Take care, everyone. I miss you. We miss you. GA misses you. I hope you have a great summer, and I hope to see you soon. Thanks for your attention, and thanks for watching. Bye.